You might have heard about many incidences that there are some hidden cameras which has been placed in the trial room, in the bathroom, in the bedroom of any hotel. You have to be very cautious and aware whenever you are going to such places. It has been observed that some people are having a tendency to watch another woman when she is in her private space. Now here, private space, anything where any other person is not supposed to see her. Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha, and in this video we are going to discuss about section 354C of IPC, that is voyeurism. Voyeurism is derived from the French word voyeur, which means to see. In Hindi, it is chipkar dekhna. Basically, it means the intrusions into somebody's private space. We are living in a digital era. Here, taking pictures, making videos are considered as a very, very common act, and it is common. But the thing is, when any video or any picture is taken of any of the private activity of any woman, which is not appropriate to be shared with anyone else, if that particular picture or if that particular video is taken even by her permission, and if it is shared to another person, it will amount as an offense under section 354C of the Indian Penal Code. Let's understand section 354C of the Indian Penal Code, which defines voyeurism. Any man who watches or captures the image of a woman engaging in a private act in circumstances where she would usually have the expectation of not being observed either by the perpetrator or by any other person at the behest of the perpetrator or disseminates such image shall be punished on first conviction with imprisonment of either description for a term which shall not be less than 1 year, but which may extend to 3 years, and shall also be liable to fine and be punished on a second or subsequent conviction with imprisonment of either description for a term which shall not be less than 3 years, but which may extend to 7 years, and shall also be liable to fine. Now there are certain things which needs to be understood clearly in this section. First thing is about private act. What is considered as a private act? As I said earlier also, that private act could be anything where anybody else is not supposed to see you. That could be anything which is in your bedroom, in your bathroom, or in your changing room. Any activity that is your private activity which is not supposed to be seen by anyone else. So this is first thing. Now second thing which is important to understand is, if in that particular private act, if any other person is either watching or capturing your image or making your video, all these three things will amount as an offense under IPC. The third thing which is important is dissemination. Now dissemination is something which is important factor, because even if that picture or video is taken after your permission also, the permission is not given to disseminate that picture or a video. And if any person is doing so, it will amount as an offense under the IPC. And the punishment for voyeurism is, if it is a first conviction, then the punishment may be for 1 year, which may extend it to 3 years with fine, if it is first conviction. But if it is second or subsequent conviction, then the punishment could be 3 years to 7 years and fine, depending upon the gravity of the offense the person has committed. Even in the Information Technology Act 2000, a section has been introduced in the Amendment 2008, which is related to voyeurism, which is influenced by the Section 1801 of Video Voyeurism Prevention Act of Federal Law of USA. This section states that Whoever in the special maritime and territorial jurisdiction of the United States has the intent to capture an image of a private area of an individual without their consent and knowingly does so under circumstances in which the individual has a reasonable expectation of privacy shall be fined under the title or imprisoned not more than 1 year or both. Now in this section, capture means any picture, any video, any film, any broadcast on any such thing. Here broadcast means to electronically transmit any image with an intent to viewed person to person. The Section 66E of Information Technology Act 2008 recognize the right to protect the human body from unreasonable and obscene intrusions by video technology and adequately protects the individual privacy from the crime of video voyeurism, which destroy personal privacy and dignity by secretly videotaping or photographing unsuspecting individuals. Section 67A of the Information Technology Act states that if material which is published online is sexually explicit, the person can be imprisoned for 5 years and be liable to pay a fine up to 10 lakhs. There are many provisions which has been formulated specially for women in our criminal justice system, especially in the Indian Penal Code. But that is not sufficient if you are not aware, if you are not cautious. You have to be aware because it is your responsibility first to save yourself. Then it is the responsibility of any other person to save you. So be careful, be cautious and be aware always. So that's all about voyeurism. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. You may also follow us on various social media platforms. We are having our page on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and LinkedIn. We are also having our website, that is lawcolloquy.com, where we share legal notes, legal news, journal, videos and many more things. So that's all for today. See you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.